Subscribe the channel Prostech and press the bell icon to get latest technology videos once we release. More importantly, the subscription to the channel is completely free. Friends, Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra comes with Android 10.0, One UI 2 and powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 processor with octa-core 2.73 GHz and GPU Adreno 650. Whereas Oppo F15 runs Android 9.0 Pie, Color OS 6.1 and powered by MediaTek MT6771V Helio P70 processor with octa-core 2.1 GHz with GPU Mali G72 MP3. If you see the display of this device, you can find 6.9 inches screen size with dynamic AMOLED 2X display that comes with a resolution 3200 by 1440 pixels with 511 ppi pixels density, and also comes with IP68 dust proof and water resistant up to 1.5 meters for 30 minutes and with Corning Gorilla Glass 6 screen protection. Whereas Oppo F15 is a 6.4 inches device with AMOLED display having resolution 2400 by 1080 pixels with 408 ppi density and comes with Corning Gorilla Glass 5 screen protection. Friends, talking about the internal memory, then Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra is available in different variants. One is 128GB with 12GB RAM, 256GB with also 12GB RAM and 512GB with 16GB RAM. This device also supports external micro SD XC. Friends, as far as concerned about colors for this device, then it is available in two colors. Those colors are Cosmic Gray and Cosmic. Moving on to Oppo F15, it is available in 128GB of primary storage with 8GB RAM. This phone also supports micro SD XC with dedicated slot. Friends, as far as concerned about the colors for this device, it is produced in black and unicorn white colors. If we talk about the dimension of Galaxy S20 Ultra 5G, it measures 166.9 by 76 by 8.8 mm of height, weight, thickness and 222 grams of weight with the hybrid dual nano SIM option. Whereas Oppo F15 measures 160.2 by 73.3 by 7.9 mm of height, weight, thickness and 172 grams of weight with dual nano SIM option. About the camera, then Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra 5G comes with quad cameras 108, 48, 12 and 0.3 megapixels with 1.8, 3.5, 2.2 and 1.0 apertures with wide telephoto ultra wide angles, depth sensor and 10x hybrid optical zoom. It shoot out videos of 4320p at 24 frames per second, 2160p at 30 or 60 frames per second, and other options are also with this device. It comes with HDR 10+, dual video recording, stereo and sound recording, gyro EIS and optical image stabilization, and also equipped with 40 megapixels secondary camera with 2.2 aperture 26mm wide angle PGAF, and it can record video at 2160p at 30 or 60 frames per second and 1080p at 30 frames per second.
Moving on to primary camera of Oppo F15, it comes with quad 48, 8, 2+2 megapixels primary cameras with 1.8, 2.3, 2.4 and 2.4 apertures with wide and ultra wide angles with depth sensor. It shoot out videos of 1080p at 30 frames per second and also equipped with 16 megapixel secondary camera with 2.0 aperture and with wide angle lens and video recording of 1080p at 30 frames per second.
Friends, in Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra 5G, you can find under display ultrasonic fingerprint sensor with some more sensors like gyroscope, accelerometer, proximity, compass and barometer. This phone comes with Wi-Fi, dual band, Wi-Fi direct, hotspot, Bluetooth, GPS, NFC, FM radio, 3.2 Type-C reversible connector, USB on the go, fast battery charging with 45 watt that can charge the device 100% in 58 minutes. This phone is also powered by non-removable 5000mAh battery as well.
Whereas in Oppo F15, you can find optical fingerprint sensor under display of the phone. This phone comes with some more sensors like gyroscope, accelerometer, proximity sensors and compass as well. This phone comes with Wi-Fi, dual band, Wi-Fi direct, Bluetooth, GPS, hotspot, FM radio, Type-C reversible connector, USB on the go, fast battery charging with 20 watts and powered by 4025 mAh non-removable battery as well.
So that was the quick comparison of both the smartphones. You can also check further details in the description below. What do you think about these smartphones? Do let us know in the comments section below. I hope you liked this video and don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.